You know that tomorrow is supposed to get up to 105 degrees. That means knock them out. You guys need to do the best you can, get plenty of fluids, walk on the shady sides of the street, because 9 times out of 10, if you fall out, your partner does not know first aid and CPR. You will die down there on that ground. Please, please. All right, this is a notice. Hear ye, hear ye. The crisis of the imminent closing of Monroe Park. There is a crisis looming in the near future for Monroe Park this September, following the great bicycle race in 2015. The park may be closed, then secured by armed uniformed security guards. This means that the relief rooms and water fountains will be inaccessible. It will also, what is this? Oh, this will also stop the churches and food banks, not bombs, to serve meals on the sidewalk. A worker in Monroe Park suggested this scenario to me. This is a type of socio-economic horror movie that Hollywood has not produced. The other alternative is Oregon Hill Linear Park. There are no restrooms, no benches. I doubt if the city council would finance 2 portable toilets and a water fountain during the time that Monroe Park is closed for 18 months. That is in the newspaper from last year. It is not much better than churches serving meals and giving clothes and blankets on the sidewalk. I did not mention inclement weather and the coming of darkness early in the season of autumn. This is dehumanizing, disrespectful of the poor. There is a scripture in the book of 1 Peter that especially urges one to honor the poor. The English amendment concurs that scriptures with its references that no state should have laws or ordinances that practice cruel and unusual punishment. I want you guys to know that what the city officials are doing to you is cruel and unusual punishment. It is against the law to treat a dog the way they treat some of you all. If there's an animal out in the street, they get on TV and ask you to send money to adopt a pet. Why can't they send money to adopt a poor? This is something that I want to do. Start a program on the internet and ask for donations. Plenty of donations can come in and will come in. I need your help in order to help you. A lot of you all have been screwed on. You have the right to serve. You have money, but your money is being stolen by people that are supposed to protect your money for you. There's a lot that's going on. You guys need to look out for each other. Try to travel in pairs, because if one happens, something happens to one, the other might be before the other one up. There's no time to be alone out there in the heat. Remember that. And social services, we all need to just go there and have a city. Bring the news media down there. If you don't, a lot of you all that are sitting here now will not make it through this time. This is one of the hottest summers we ever had on record. And you are not Superman and Superwoman. So my thing is, I've been volunteering and working with the homeless over 30 years. I never asked for $1. You know why? Because God got my back. I have been beaten by a 275-pound man I never seen him before, beat me in my chest, double thrust punch me. They tell me at social services to stop. Well, you can look me up on the internet. My name is Teddy, and Param Like the Road. Look me up on your phone. I got 6,000 videos showing the cruelty that this city puts on the people. And they deliberately make some people poor. And they deliberately make some people rich. If it was not for these churches and the love of God, where would you be now if the lights went out in this church? If you came here today and they
I love you guys. Drink your water, stay on the shady side of the street, and do not get out there and buy that alcohol. Cause if I see you laying down there cause you drunk, I'm not giving you first aid. I'm gonna walk past you, okay? It's too hot to be stupid. Save that money, ride a bus, get off the street, cause at 5 o'clock, everything is gonna be closed down. No bathroom, no water. What you gonna do all night tonight? No shelter, prairie tops closing down. We need to fight this and we're bigger than they are. You understand? You all have power that you have not even tapped into. Each of you are somebody, and you got a role to play. The last thing I want to do is to help you guys get a shelter, and the Redskin team going to build it for you. God is my witness. You watch, because I'm working on them suckers. They can come in here and don't pay taxes. You all have to pay taxes on everything you buy. These people are multi-millionaires. Why don't they pay taxes? Because Dwight Jones set it up that way. And we need to pray and ask God to pull them out of office quick. There's too much evil going on in this city. And we are not perfect. But we are some of the blessed ones. So I want you all to get yourselves together. Know when you leave this building, Satan is trying to kill me. Thank God for my elder and the members of this church. We don't even attend this church, but their house is open for you to feed you, to help you, to love you, to give you things. And stop going around taking things that don't belong to you. Some of y'all like Lightfinger Lewis. Some of the churches would be open at night for you. If you kept your hands off the things that belong to the church. Don't go up in the church stealing the communion mugs and all of that. What you think? What kind of love you think you're going to have stealing from the only one that cares about you? So I'm just saying, tough love is all I got. I don't play no games except on the board. And each of you, life is too precious, and I love you. That's what's wrong. There's not enough love. There's not enough hugs. But we can change this city up. And remember, we are one race, the human race. And when you're poor, it don't matter what color you are. Trust and believe you're at the bottom of the line. So I love you guys. Know that their park gonna close down. Know that Canal Plaza, they getting ready to lock that down. Where you gonna go? Where they won't even put a porta john out there. I've been scrambling trying to get them to put some bathrooms outside. If you eat, if you drink, you're gonna have to go to the bathroom. What, you gonna walk around smelling like urine? No, you don't have to do that. But together, we need to learn and love each other and stop being afraid. None of us are perfect. We've all screwed up. But see, I don't have a problem getting on my knees talking to my Father at night. I think about all of you because I love you. And that's how important you are to me. So I've been here 30 plus years working in the school system. They can't stand me. They lock me up, keep my door in, drum up charges. But the only reason, and I'm going to tell this to you, the only reason that I haven't went to City Hall and took all them suckers down like them boy did in the church and took some of these senators and Congress down, you know why? I ain't scared to die. Because I'm a warrior. That's what warriors do. We fight. You know why? I'm not going to jail because I'm on medication every day from being beat half to death. But other than that, if I thought they would give me my meds in jail, I'm like, get my sweet red because I'm coming. Jesus won't scare you to go to jail. Sometimes you can be innocent and they treat you like the worst crook in the world. You think I went to school and studied for real estate all of these years and the white folk wouldn't even let me sell real estate? That's how racist they are here. I could build us a building. Do you think that I went to school all of the years and studied law and they wouldn't even let me finish law school? You know I must be powerful. And my God is a good God. But I know this. What goes around comes around. Each of you all have been blessed and anointed by the best. If you don't believe it, go look in the mirror and see what you see. Thank you. I love y'all.
Numbers 3100.
If any of you are having problems getting your benefits, the people stealing your money, let me know so I can go with you. Take me on your next appointment. I'm begging you to take me. They playing them games. They telling you they can't give you the food stamp. Take me with you and see how they react once they see my funny looking face. I ain't scared at all. All right.
Okay.
WB the photographer, that's right.